Welcome to GYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Geography, Environment and Ecology, Polity, etc. So what we are doing in these series, we daily cover 5 questions of each topic, and in this way we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC Civil Services examination, and we will end these series only one day before your prelims exam. So friends, recently we have launched the geography series, and we are only on the lecture number 3. Already we have covered the 47 lectures of environment and ecology, and on ancient India we are on the lecture number 18. So certain series we have already started earlier, so but certain series we have started just now. So for example, geography. So what we do in these series, as I have told you, that we daily cover 5 questions. So if we have 6 series currently that are prelims oriented, that are targeting the prelims of 2019, so if 5 questions are covered in each video, then six, you can multiply it with 6, then 30 questions are covered daily from your prelims point of view. So friends, if you go by rough calculation, then by 31st May we will be covering nearly 1000 questions of each topic. So it is not just 1000 questions, they are kind of 4000 concepts. So how 1000 becomes 4000? Because friends, UPSC is not just about seeing a question and seeing its answer. UPSC is about seeing why a particular answer is correct and why other options are incorrect, and in which context they will be correct. So each regarding each option you see the explanation. So in this way, each question covers your 4 concepts. So you can multiply it with 4. So 1000 questions will cover your 4000 concepts, so which will be much helpful during the time of revision. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, consider the following statements. First is that a given apparent position of sun in the sky, all places on the same longitude receive the same amount of solar insolation. Second is, sun is overhead at the same time for all locations with the same latitude. Regarding first statement, friends, first statement is incorrect. First statement is incorrect, because at the same longitude, how could a place could receive similar insolation for solar insolation? For example, this is the earth and this is a line of longitude. If the sun is here, for example, if it is here on equator, then obviously it will receive, these places will receive different amount of sunlight. This place will receive maximum amount of sunlight because it is directly overhead here, and in these regions the sunlight will be, solar insolation will be inclined, so it will not be that much. So for that purpose, the insolation is different at different points, at different points. In case they lie in same longitude. And also, friend, second statement is incorrect. Sun is overhead at the same time for all locations with same latitude. This is also incorrect. For example, if the sun is in overhead on equator, then how could be it is on overhead at these places, if it is overhead at this place? And also, if it is overhead at all the places, then earth is a kind of a sphere, then it will be a day at over entire earth. But you see that half of the earth has experiences day and half of the earth experiences night at the same time. So this is also not correct. So the correct answer is C, that is both. Correct answer is D, that is none. So this is the solution. So already I have explained to you in great detail. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, oil and gas deposits cannot be found in sandstones and coarse grained limestones. And reason is given is, structural traps cannot be formed in sandstones and limestones. So we have to consider whether they are right or wrong, or whether if A is right, if the R is correct explanation of it or not. So let me tell you, friends, that both these statements are wrong, because oil and gas deposits are mainly found in sandstone and coarse grained limestones. They are the major deposits they are kind of ideal rocks for the deposit of oil and gas deposits, that is the sandstones and coarse grained limestones, because they are solid and they have a sponge. They are basically sponge in solid form. So the gas, they have the structural traps within them. So the gas and the oil is deposited between these sandstones and grained limestones, coarse grained limestones. So both A and R are incorrect. So the answer is D. So solution is D. So the explanation is provided in explanation PDF, and what is it? I will provide. I will tell you later in the coming presentation. So let's come to the third question. Third question is, consider the following matches of rivers with their region source. First is Narmada, Mekal Hills. Second is Chambal, Singar Chori Peak. Third is Tapi, Satpura Range. So let me tell you, friends, that all are correct with their source of region. Narmada originates from Mekal Hills, that is Amarkantak Plateau, and Chambal is also originates from Singar Chori Peak. It is in basically in northern Vindhyas, Vindhyan escarpment. So regarding third, Tapi is also it originates from Satpura Range, and it flows westward and falls enters the Arabian Sea. So all are correctly matched. So the correct option is D, that is 1, 2, and 3. So the explanation in detail is provided in explanation PDF, that which areas they basically drain and with they form which the tributary of which main river. So all these things are in explanation PDF. So fourth question is, which one of the following matches is incorrect? A is Gobi Desert, Mongolia. B is Bering Strait International Rate Line. C is Mount Kilimanjaro, Africa. D is Andes Mountain, South Africa. So let me tell you, friends, that A is also correct, because Gobi Desert is in South Mongolia and northern China, and Bering Strait is a strait. Basically, it connects Arctic Sea with Pacific Ocean and divides Russia and USA, and through it the international date line passes. This is also correct. If you have seen the atlas, then you will be able to answer it. Regarding C, this is also correct, because Mount Kilimanjaro is in Africa and it is a dormant volcano in Africa. And regarding D, friends, this is incorrect, because but let me tell you that most of the students will get confused in it. Please don't do anything in a hurried manner. Please note, when you will attempt the exam, please notice every option carefully. Andes Mountain is in South America and not in South Africa. So here is the mistake that the students will commit. So please note this correctly. So the D answer is correct answer of this question. So explanation in detail, that where they are found and what are they basically and what are their features, it is provided in explanation PDF. So let's move on to the fifth question, that is the last question of geography lecture. Which of the following factors affect the generation flow of equatorial westerlies? So friends, you know that equatorial westerlies flow over the equator towards the east direction from west direction. So that's why they are called westerlies. We have to consider the statements regarding it. First is movement of intertropical convergence zone. Second is Coriolis force caused due to rotation of Earth. So we have to consider which of the following factors affect their generation flow. So friends, let me tell you that both these intertropical convergence zone and Coriolis force due to the rotation of Earth affects the westerlies and their flow. So the correct answer is both 1 and 2. So regarding explanation that how they affect it is provided in the explanation PDF, because it is not possible to explain everything in this video. But because there is a much difference in an offline class and in an online class. In an online class, we speak continuously for 15 to 20 minutes and it becomes hectic. So friends, what is this explanation PDF? It is basically as clear from the name, it is explanation of the question, that is why a particular option is correct and why others are not correct, and what are they basically, and in which context they will be correct, and what are the other they are all other things are included in explanation PDF. So they are kind of a lifeblood of UPSC preparation. If you, for example, let me tell you, friends, that at the end of the day, when your exam will be near, you will not be able to read standard books again and again, because they become boring. And also, at that time, you will have much time, much not much time. You will have much different topic, many topics to revise. Also, at that time, you will have economic survey to cover, Indian yearbook to cover, budget to cover. So there will be multiple things at that time. So at that time, you must have some certain thing, a certain kind of thing, which help you in revising your concepts, important concepts, in a quick manner and doesn't lead to wastage of time. Because also videos waste your time when you see them at the time of revision, because 20 to 25 minute video will obviously waste your time. If you are wasting 25 minutes for just 5 questions, then it is totally absurd. So friends, in that case, you must have some kind of notes from which you can revise quickly. So this these question and answer format is the best tested method. for revision, because the UPSC method is not just about seeing the answer, it is also about seeing the explanation. So in this manner, the question is also designed in keeping in mind the pattern that is followed by UPSC, and also questions are included from the previous UPSC question papers. So these question answer format is the best way. So these cover basically the important concepts only, and also they cover them comprehensively when you see the explanation of them, that because that why a particular option is incorrect. So in this way, if you want to ensure your that you clear your prelims, then please do subscribe to these question and answer explanation PDFs, because these will solve your purpose, because you will not get bored by revising them, because you will see question and then you will see answer, and also then if your answer is incorrect, then you will go for explanation. So this keeps your curiosity at high level when you experience the extreme pressure. So in this way you can revise quickly. So this is the time tested method I'm telling you, and obviously at the time of prelims, after prelims, I'm sure that certain students will certainly say me that yes sir, you were right. If we had followed your method, we could have done better in the exam. So I don't want this to happen with any student, so please do follow them. So friends, if you want to subscribe to them, we are not charging much. They are basically we are covering geography from four angles, that is human geography, political geography, economic geography, and your physical geography. So we are covering four angles of geography. So we are charging for that purpose ₹400 for the entire PDFs of geography. So in just paying ₹400, you will get all the PDFs that of the previous lectures and that we are going to cover till 31st May. So you will get them in just a single time payment of ₹400. So this is, if you want to subscribe, you can subscribe to them. So this is the explanation for the details that we have different series also, like of environment, ancient India, medieval India, modern India. So costs are different for different, but geography is the most costly because it we cover it from different angles, and we have to pick the questions from with great effort, keeping in mind everything in mind, so that every angle is covered. Your political angle is also covered, your economic angle, human angle, and physical angle is also covered. So friends, if you can also subscribe to the complete package of them. The total amounts to 950, but if you want to get the complete package, then you can get in ₹800. We are offering you a discount of ₹150 on the complete package. So why we are charging, friends? Basically, we also want certain kind of motivation for maintaining the consistency. If we people don't charge you, then we will also become lax, and in that manner we will not cover your things in a proper manner. Because obviously, if you have paid us, then we will have certain kind of obligation to provide service to you. So already we have 40 to 50 students that have subscribed to our initiatives. So if you want to become a part of team Achieve IAS, then you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481, and we will provide you the details. And already I have provided you, you can subscribe to our initiative. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Lastly, friends, let me tell you that we have a Telegram channel also, the link of which I have provided in the description box. So you can check the description box and can join our Telegram channel by checking the link in the description box. And friends, those who don't know how to join the Telegram channel, for those students, let me tell you that there is an app called eSandesh. It is an unofficial app of Telegram. You can download it from Google Play Store, as well as it is also available on App Store. So it is totally free of cost. There is no cost of downloading it. When you will download it, you will see here a search box, and what you will have to do, you will have to just copy and paste the link of my channel here, and in this way you will get to my channel, and then you can join it and can remain tuned with us. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you liked it, please like it, please share it with your friends, and please comment if you have any suggestion. I will certainly consider it. And please, friends, subscribe to our channel, and please do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the notifications of important updates that we do on our YouTube platform, YouTube channel, regarding the CSE 2019. So thank you.